Hi, I'm Bruce Bauer. I'm a scientist with NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. I specialize in paleoclimatology, which is the study of past climate change.
What can we learn from tree rings?
One of the things that we use to tell us about how climate has changed in the past is tree rings. You probably know that trees can tell you how old they are by how many rings they have. I have a sample here. You might be able to see a little bit of the rings there. The trees in temperate climates do grow one ring per year, so they can tell you how old they are. The reason that they do this is because in the wintertime, the trees are, it's too cold for them to photosynthesize and grow. So the trees will sleep for the winter. In the springtime, they start to grow and they put a ring of wood under the bark. And wood for trees is mostly made up of xylem cells, which essentially function as straws. So in the springtime, when the trees are first growing, they make a cell that's pretty large. So the empty space of the straw cell, the xylem cell, is light tan in color. And in the fall, in the late summer and fall, they make a smaller cell with a heavier wall. So to our naked eye, because the straws are too small to see, that looks more like a dark chocolate color. So the light tan is spring wood, and the dark layer is late wood or summer wood, and the two of them together make an annual ring. So each season, each year, the tree grows a new ring. So it can tell us how old it is, but it can also tell us how much it grew from year to year. So the widths of rings will change over time. So what the tree can tell us is not only how old it is, but how much it grew. And in many cases, how much it grew is dependent on the weather it experienced that year. So in a dry climate like the Western United States, the trees will grow best when they get most water. So in a wet year, they'll grow best. In a drought year, they'll grow poorly. Conversely, trees in cold climates are controlled by the temperature that they see during the season. In Scandinavia or Alaska or high mountain areas, the growing seasons are short. Summers are short and cool. So a warm year will actually produce better tree growth than a cold year. So depending on where the tree's growing, the scientists will take samples from the trees, measure the ring widths, and compare that with weather records. And if there is a good statistical comparison, then we can say, yes, these trees are telling us about rainfall in some areas or temperature in other areas. And so the trees can tell us not only how old they are, but what climate conditions they have experienced during their lifetimes. And some of the trees in temperate zones can live to be a very great age. We have some species that'll live to be over 2,000 years. So we can produce a temperature or rainfall history from where the tree was growing for much longer than people have been around measuring those phenomena. So we can see changes in climate up to about 2,000 years with tree rings for areas around the world. And we use that to understand the natural changes in climate that have occurred in the last several thousand years, because the tree rings tell us what they have experienced, and then we can understand the difference between that and climate change that's currently occurring and it's caused by humans.